sorry.
No, it's okay. Take your time. Okay. Have you been recording this whole time?
Yes.
No.
Okay. Do diseases in striped bass affect you? Oh, God. Okay, so some background on striped bass. They're one of the most important species in the Chesapeake Bay. They're commonly caught for sport and for food. They offer a lot of health benefits, like vitamin B12, which is one of the 13 essential vitamins that your body needs. And they're obviously a good source of protein. So a lot of them have been recently been caught with lesions, like white and red lesions present on their skin. It's a result of a bacterial infection called mycobacteriosis, and B for short. It's from parasites that are in the water, and they get into their, they burrow into their skin and cause the welts. Humans, so the parasites are most prevalent in areas where there's like a lot of them crammed in one area, like for commercial fishing and aquaculture. Stuff. And this, when there's like a lot of them and there's warm temperatures, there's that's the environment that they thrive, the parasites thrive in. And when they're in, once they get into the skin, they are protected from like the environment, so they don't die. And then in, because the bass are in this crammed environment, their immune systems are going down, so they can't fight the infection. Important because the striped bass with that have this infection, like we can't keep them. So when the anglers have to limit their catch now, and that causes them to lose money. And awesome, yeah, their population is decreasing. This obviously kills them eventually. So there's no evidence that actually eating the cooked, if it's cooked, eating the striped bass will hurt you, but it can, or the ones that are infected, but the MB can be transmitted through contact if proper handling techniques aren't being used. So using glove, like if you have a open cut, or wound, the infection can get into your skin. It's not very common, but it pretty much has the same, and it has the same effect as it does on the stripe on the bass. It just creates the lesions on your skin. It also attacks the kidney, the kidneys, liver, and spleen. So VIMS right now is doing research to find out more about the infection. And see, just to see how it's really affecting the whole population and how it can mess up the economic things involved with this. Like, obviously, if you catch less, we make less money. So, really, if you just plan fishing for striped bass, any that are, any with lesions present, which, by the way, not all of the ones that are infected have the lesions, but that's just, like, the main warning sign. But obviously, you can't keep them, throw them back. Limit your catch, because this, since they're already dying from the infection, catching, we need to limit the catch so that their population can replenish. And any, if there is, then you need to throw back, you have to do it quickly and efficiently because their stress levels, or to avoid making them more stressed, because when they're under these or when they're stressed, the immune system is weakened, so they're even more susceptible to the infection.